Welcome to KSTP.com. I'm Corey Campshire. He is Judd Zolgad from 1500 ESPN. Judd, the Vikings pretty much did as I expected them to do last night. Maybe not quite as bad.
I was going to say, that bad? Did you realize it could be that bad?
But I thought it would be bad, but just not quite that bad. But boy, Ponder is not, I mean, he's just not good.
You could say he's not good at all. You know, I think it's an interesting game because the Vikings start the season with an impressive win in St. Louis and then a loss. And this goes back to this whole stretch, this early season stretch, which really goes through next Sunday's game against Detroit, which is if they can get off to a decent start, it's not bad. They're 2-3 right now. But here's a problem with the Green Bay game last night. You almost have to throw the offensive film away completely. Once Teddy Bridgewater, with that sprained ankle, couldn't start and Christian Ponder got the start, what we saw from Ponder is Ponder. And in some ways, he was set up to fail and, in my opinion, put in a very unfair situation for him. He's a guy who, number one, shouldn't have made the roster. They could have picked up any third-string quarterback along the way. They could have actually had a better roster construction if they had kept a young player on the roster. And it didn't have to be a quarterback, just a young player that they liked. They don't like Ponder. And then this whole notion that, oh, man, it's good they kept Christian Ponder because he's your third quarterback. It's folly for this reason. Norv Turner's offense is as familiar to Christian Ponder as it is to me. Christian Ponder got almost no reps in Mankato. He didn't play in the middle two preseason games. So for people that are thinking, oh man, Christian Ponder sat in a classroom, yes, he did. But he really hasn't basically gotten a chance to practice this offense. So Christian Ponder is a bad quarterback, was put in a position to fail. But all of that being said, Corey, as I just said, you almost throw away the offensive film completely from last night. You assume in 9 days when the Vikings play host to the Lions that Bridgewater starts. The offense won't be great, but it will be better. The most disconcerting things that you probably see on film is from the defense. The run defense has to improve. The secondary has to improve. But, you know, keep in mind, the Packers scored, I want to say, on two of their first six possessions. Four of those first six were punts. So the defense has areas to improve. They weren't absolutely awful, but the fact of the matter was Christian Ponder was, and that was enough to bury the Vikings.
Two things. One, I kind of feel bad. Call me crazy, but I kind of feel bad for Ponder. Well, I mean, he seems like a nice guy.
He's a very nice guy, and he's a very smart guy. He's just not a good football player.
Right. And so I kind of feel bad for him. But then on top of that, there were a lot of mistakes the Vikings made last night that I noticed. Some stupid penalties, some just not very well disciplined.
Everson Griffin jumps offside. Yeah, right. The defense, that's where I go back to. I think if you really want to look at that game on Thursday night against the Packers and say, this worries me, that worries me, where you really find it is on the defense, because the players playing on defense are going to play for you. Offensively, you throw the whole thing away because, okay, Peterson's gone, and your running game is certainly not ideal. But think of all the things that worked on offense against Atlanta. And a lot of those things were geared on the fact that Teddy Bridgewater is playing quarterback. And I'm not trying to say for 1 second that Teddy Bridgewater is an MVP or a Pro Bowl player. But what we have to give him the benefit of the doubt on until he proves otherwise, and he hasn't yet, is that he is a competent National Football League quarterback. And I can say without doubt that last night you did not have a competent National Football League quarterback playing for you, and you actually had a guy who I thought might stick around the league as a backup for a while. But Christian Ponder, the way I saw him last night, might not even belong in this league. It's that bad.
Judd Zolgad, you can hear him 9 to 1 every day, Monday through Friday.
It'll get
and
better
on
by
Saturday.
It should get better.
10 to noon as well.
Yes.
Hey, hockey season's next week, so we got that going for us.
Exactly right. Wild starts next week.
Next week, Thursday.
Gopher Hockey has a preseason game or exhibition game on Saturday night.
How about that? You can hear him on the radio, by the way. Thanks, Judd.
1500 ESPN.